Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory be to God in the highest. And that peace be unto all men, on whom his favor rests. Amen. Living to please God. Amen. God said to me to start from Romans chapter 12. That's where we're starting from. Living to please God. Thank you, Jesus. I'm going to look at it in the Amplified. Thank you, Jesus. Yeah. I said this before, I'm going to say it again, and that is this. Anybody ever seen an African attire before? Sometimes a big, really big one, and it goes like this on both sides, and they have a hat and a cap and everything that goes with it, and it's matching, and it look elegant, and it look royal. Sometimes you see some of the ladies, I mean, it's like they come out of a magazine or something like that. But you see, if you want to make an African attire, you don't use a pattern of a suit. Like coat, whatever pattern you use, that's what you're going to get. You've been trying to use a pattern of a suit to look at African attire. I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, by the mercies of God. Hallelujah. Amplify Romans chapter 12 verse 1. Therefore, all you brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to present your bodies, dedicate not all of yourself. When you say present of your body, it means to dedicate all of yourself. My body, my spirit, my soul. Dedicate all of myself. To set apart as a living sacrifice. As a living sacrifice. My spirit, my soul, my body, dedicated to God as a living sacrifice. As a living sacrifice. It's living your life, but it's a sacrifice to God. Since it's a sacrificial living. You have to tell your body, my body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. If the mind is not dedicated, then the mind is not renewed. When the mind is not renewed, wherever the mind goes, that's where the body goes, the body follows. Body is neutral, it follows the mind. If the mind is not renewed, the body will take you. The mind will take the body to the wrong places. Hallelujah. Present your bodies, dedicating all of them. Yourself set apart as a living sacrifice, holy and well pleasing to God. Holy and well pleasing to God. Living to please God. It begins with your mind. It begins with our mind. The mind needs to be renewed. It begins with us recognizing that God lives in us. The Bible says your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. What's the temple? That's where he lives. He said, I want to dwell permanently in the temple. So if you don't have a revelation that you are the temple, then you take the temple to all the wrong places. God said, wait a minute. I paid for this temple with my own blood. And that's what grieves God. When you take someone that is paid for with his own blood to the wrong places. You are not on your own. You have been bought with a price. Glorify God with your body that belongs to God, your spirit that belongs to God. Your eye is part of your body. Make up your mind, you don't look at people lustfully, because if you do, you will pray for the enemy. In the spirit realm, when a Christian compromise, it's like a little snowball in the spirit. In the physical, you're running like a lion, like a little snowball that you can just kick like this. When you walk in the anointing, when you make up your mind, when you go with God all the way, then in the spirit ring, like a ring of fire. People walk close to you and they take off running without you saying anything. The devil knows what you are and who's not, and it's not what you say. See, the spirit realm, you understand what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. There's a spirit realm and there's a physical realm. So how do you look in the spirit realm? God wants you to be really, really on fire for God. Yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. So don't be a prayer for the devil to mess up with your life. Amen. We say we're filled with the Holy Spirit. Walk with him. Yeah. Be empowered by him. Yeah. Love what God loves and hate what God hates. Amen. When nobody's watching, live a life of integrity. Yeah. Always be God inside minded. All the God conscious. All the God conscious. God will keep you if you want to be kept.
Yes, he will.
Temptation is high when the mind is not renewed.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah. The Bible says, greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. When was the last time you quote that scripture? You know, oh, I'm just going through a whole lot of things. That's what you say. Oh, I just don't know if you can make it. That's what you say. That's not what the Bible says. No wonder you go through all kinds of trouble. Death and life are in the power of the tongue. God said, I want you to be, you are an overcomer. That's what God said about you. And if you live in less than being an overcomer, then you're not pleasing to God. Because he died. He shed his blood on the cross of Calvary. Jesus shed his blood on the cross of Calvary so he can be an overcomer. Yeah. Not just something you say with the lip. It's how you live. Yeah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Hey, glory. Thank you.
Present your bodies, dedicating all of yourself, set apart as a living sacrifice. As a living sacrifice, holy. Rule number one thing for the please God is what? Holy. See, without holiness, no man shall see God. What does it mean to be holy? It means to be set aside for God's use only. To be set aside for God's use only. For God's use only. This is a recording. Holiness is to be set aside for God's use only. Both in the mind, in the spirit, and in the body. For God's use only. The devil would like to borrow what belongs to God's use only.
Yeah.
If you then.
Yeah.
Living sacrifice holy and well pleasing to God, which is your rational. God said this is the norm. When you are born again, the norm is to be used for God's use only. When you are born again, the norm is to be sanctified, set aside for God's use only. Why would Christ shed his blood on the cross of Calvary? He died in excruciating pain so he can have you as for himself, for God's use only. Put the devil in your life for God's use only. He paid the price in full. Living to please God. We have to make up your mind who we will serve. Amen. Said to say yourself outside as a living sacrifice, holy and well pleasing to God, which is a rational, logical, intelligent act of worship. Your reasonable service. God said, I'm not asking for too much when you walk in holiness. I empower you to walk in holiness. I want to fellowship with you. God is holy. Without holiness, no man shall see God. God said, I want to be able to have an access to your spirit as a woman without any disturbances. If the president of the country said he wants to come to your house, or somebody you really know, he's going to have a secret vault and everything, and paper, and everything else, just a junky house, empty dishes, just do it by the door, you know, this with things in it. So you come and see dishes and cigarette butts and everything that goes along with it. I just want to tell you I love you. I ask you to love today. I ask you to work with God. Have you made up your mind? You want to go with God all the way. Because if you do, it will empower you. God says, I'm sick of nominal Christians.
Yeah,
I empower you, but you're getting my power. Because you don't want to walk in holiness.
Hallelujah.
Without holiness, no man shall see God. Yeah. You pray for the enemy when you choose to disobey God.
Yes, sir. Sir. Thank you, Lord.
Living to please God. He said, present your body as a living sacrifice. Living sacrifice, dedicating all of yourself, dedicating all of myself. My spirit, my soul, and my body is dedicated to God.
Yeah.
I'm not saying it's going to be easy. It's a matter of making up your mind in advance. So it's not difficult to decide. When you start to make decisions, are you listening to me? If you don't make up your mind in advance, you're going to be sold out to God all the way. When it's time for you to make decisions, you're going to struggle. Because you are in between. How long will you be talking between two opinions? If God is not, go with him if it's not living alone.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. Did you hear what I said?
Yeah.
Don't get between two opinions. You're going to destroy yourself if you do that. You destroy your testimony. God said, I'm sick of it. We're in the last of the last days.
Yeah.
Look around, the harvest is white. And you are the harvesters.
Yeah.
And I will use you mightily for my glory.
Yeah,
the time has come. You cannot afford for you to get mad because of what somebody did to you. You better get up that thing quickly.
Yes,
you so sad and go to hell and worry about what somebody did to you. What's your problem?
Yeah.
Don't be a grumpy complainer. Get up that thing in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
Complain about everything.
Yeah. Yeah.
Your mouth is anointed.
Yeah.
Pray over this.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Learn to please God.
Hallelujah.
To please God is very easy. Find out what God wants to do, what the Bible says God wants you to do, start doing it without complaining, without grumbling.
Yeah.
Don't do God's will reluctantly.
Yeah.
Man look on the outer, the appearance, but God look in the heart.
Yeah.
If your heart is not right with God, you can do whatever you want, it won't work.
Right.
God said, you don't really mean it. God said, I don't want a lip service from you.
Mm-hmm.
We thank you to be a living sanctuary. A living sanctuary,
yeah.
When was the last time you worship God like you never worshiped Him before? When was the last time you make up a mind to do God's will without any resentful spirit? Some of them, they will never tell you they want to just do with resentment.
Yes.
I have a designing spirit.
Yes.
I may not say anything. Mm-hmm. If I don't tell you, I'll be resentful. I mean, this gladness of it, I can pick it up just like this.
Mm-hmm.
Just like that.
Yes.
Say, Lord, anoint me. So, no, sir, I can't put my anointing on resentment. God said, I don't want you to resent me in your heart. I want to welcome me wholeheartedly.
Yeah.
I don't go where I'm not invited. Even though I pay for you in full, if you're satisfied, to go into a different level, that's fine. Level 1 from 1 to 2. Remember I told you I had a dream. I met somebody. And they said she's supposed to be my wife. And I was a praying man. I said, Lord, reveal this to me. Let me know. Many of us need to be very careful to get involved sexually with folk before you get married. You just got to messing up your life. And you better repent and God will forgive you. You can be kind to God, you can increase your time offering. That would not make up for repentance. Turn away from my wicked ways and talk towards God and be sincere. Let the repentance prove that if you go back, then you haven't repented yet. Don't you ever go back. Stay with God.
Yeah, thank you.
Every promise of God for you, they are yes and they are amen. It may not look like it or feel like it. It shall come to pass.
Yeah.
The vision that God has for your life, it may look like it's tarrying, like it's taking time, but write it down. It will not be delayed. God is a never late God.
Yeah,
He loves you. You are so precious. You are fearfully and wonderfully made.
Yeah,
you are more than conqueror. Do not look at other people's life to compare your life. They compare themselves with themselves. They measure themselves with themselves. They are not wise. He said nothing. They are stupid or foolish. They are not wise. That's so nice. Foolish or stupid. Thank you, Jesus. God said, I have a tailor-made plan for your life. And as you please me, I lead the truth one step at a time. I lead you. I guide you. I protect you. I empower you. Never compare yourself with anybody else. Don't ever do that. You are fearfully and wonderfully made. You are a group belonging to God. You are a royal priesthood. You are a holy nation. You are a peculiar people. You have been called out of darkness into His marvelous light. You belong to God. In the midst of a crooked and a perverse generation, God said, I want you to shine as stars for me, as you hold on to the word of life, not to perversiveness.
Yeah.
You shine as stars as you hold on to the word of life. It's the word of life that makes you shine.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
The entrance of the world, give a light, give understanding to the simple. Hallelujah.
Hey, thank you.
Live it to please God. Make up your mind. God said, I will, hallelujah.
Hey,
I will open the blinder.
Yeah.
Yes,
so you can see what I see in your life.
Hallelujah.
You pass out if it's not what you have for your life.
Thank you, Lord.
You pass out if God opened the blinder to let you see what you. Oh, my goodness, it's for me.
Wow.
You don't see what I mean? If they see that, they never follow me. Let me entice them with something. Let me entice them with something. Let me put the interest. Because the fire burns the devil in the spirit.
Yeah.
But the snowball, you can just kick it like this and it's gone. Small
yeah.
Snowball. Because I want to be on fire for
you.
The fire burns the draws.
Yeah.
See, this fire is started with love.
Yeah.
The fire, the love of God.
Thank you. Hallelujah.
Love what God knows and take what God hates.
Yeah.
Because you love righteousness and you hate iniquity. Therefore, the Lord that God has anointed thee with all of God above thy fellow man.
Thank you.
Everybody wants to be anointed, but holiness is real.
Yeah.
Dream on.
Right.
you don't feel anointed. When you're anointed for you can say one or two words, the whole place will be turned around.
Amen.
God says, I want you to seek me with all your heart. Like you've never seen me before. Make up your mind. I'm going with God. We're in the last of the last days. I'm telling you, it's a lot of battle for souls in the heavenlies. And the saints are sitting down eating popcorn and chicken and walking on forgiveness and don't do that. Don't do that. There's this paradigm shift in the spirit. If you are spiritual, you see. It's not the way it used to be anymore. The devil have a very, very short time left. And as many as he can take with him, he will take it well. He will have somebody who, somebody who has not seen in 20 years will call you up. Some of the old Edmund Kuhn will call you up. Baby, what are you doing? I know you're not even doing it. Is you still saved? How are you doing? I'm just checking. I'm just going through the Facebook and happen to see you. We can just come together, any or nothing. I know you're saved. Devil tell you, I know you're saved. It will hold everything.
Will.
If there's no interest, you can't do the appointment. Yeah, that's right, we can meet. Yeah, we can meet up. Yeah, we meet up in church. Yeah, we can meet up. You have a Bible for me? I'm serious. We can pray, get it. Who called? What time? Let me see. 11 o'clock. Well, the mayor to tell. Ooh, I'm telling you, man. We can meet here. We have a church there. And you tell, that sounds good to me. I don't do nothing. He shows the church. What? I thought there would be any mayor. I was expecting the bed. I got the church. Thank you, Jesus. Your life is so precious to me, said the Lord. Go to the devil and come. You cannot afford to play hooky with your life anymore. You belong to me. I love with an everlasting love. Make every effort to please me in every way. Do the work of the ministry. Put your hope in God. When you pray, trust me to answer your prayer. I gave my blood to give you access to the throne of grace. And you doubting me, it's part of my blood that gives you the access. Don't you ever, it's an insult to doubt God when you pray. Because you refuse to acknowledge that the access is paid for the blood of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
What does he want you to do, said the Lord? He shall come to pass before you call. I will answer. While you are here speaking, I will hear. Hallelujah. Oh, glory be to God this morning.
Yeah, thank you.
Leave me to please God. Make up your mind. Make up your mind. Make up your mind. That person is coming. He's coming to destroy you. Yes, we have a very short time left.
Hallelujah.
We have a very short time left. We live in the sense of miracles.
Amen.
A miracle is something that happens almost instantly. Almost instantly. Almost instantly.
Amen.
Many of you are in the fact of quitting because I haven't seen anything. God said, you better not do that. Amen. Don't quit before your miracle. If you do, you'll never find out what I have for you.
You
won't take long enough. You're in the fact of a breakthrough and you quit because you don't feel like it. Don't you ever do that.
Yeah,
I said, that's a stupid thing to do. The most thing you can do is to quit before the breakthrough. Because you're discouraged. Because it didn't look like it's supposed to be. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you,
let me tell you something. There was a lady at the conference. How many of you are at the conference?
Amen.
There was a lady at the conference. She's a pastor of a church. She was going through.
Yeah.
She was a giver.
Yeah.
She did everything that God told her to do. Mm-hmm. And then some of the members of the church of her just stopped giving the tithe. They just stopped giving the tithe. I don't know if she preached a message. They didn't, I don't know whatever happened. They didn't give the tithe like they're supposed to. And she had to give some of her own personal finances to make up for it. And so she was discouraged. She felt she can't even go to a conference. Struggling with the bills of the church. How can I go to a conference like that? That doesn't make any sense to go to a conference. Holy Spirit said, I want you to go. When she got there, the bishop talking about children preaching. IPod, they call it. Internal preacher academy something, whatever it was. IPod, they call it. with young people preaching. They said, for people to give $1,000. She said, what? All I have is $100. So she wrote it down. She said, well, I don't have it.
Yeah.
He said, it's painful for us to want to give and not have it.
Right.
But she was saying that. Oh, he said, look at that young lady. She said, short lady too. He said, I want the church to bless with $5,000. I'm thinking, my brother couldn't be good. Because we have to confirm the spirit. You can't just go on what you feel.
Yes, sir.
I had that. I look at her. Pull back. We worship the Lord. Put your hand down. Look at her again. All the people said, the $5,000. Your church. She's going through. And she's stressful. She's one of mine.
Hey, Lord.
I said, Lord, let me tell you what I tell you, Lord. I said, Lord, the finances of the church belong to you.
Yeah.
You have the right to do whatever you want to do with it at any given place at the point in the time. So we left the place. Mm-hmm. I went to the restroom. While I was washing my hand, Bully, I went to give them $5,000 to the church. I got to the place, went to Wendy's. They give me a chicken. I said, give me a chicken and have bony. I want a church. $5,000. Wow. I went to the hotel. I said, let me just see if I can just sit up for the blue. While I was trying to take off my shoe, bony. I want the church. $5,000. She's one of mine. I said, okay, Lord. I'm thinking, how am I going to find her? I'm not used to her. I don't even know who she was. So I went earlier. They said, come in at 6:30 or something, at 6 o'clock. So I said, let me wash my hand, in the restroom, I washed my hand, I came out. Guess who was standing by the registration? That lady, all by herself. She didn't know why she was there.
Yeah, God.
She had no status idea. Right. When I came out, she was right in the hospital and said, that woman, don't tell me, don't know. Right now, right here. He standing by herself. I said, okay, I got it now. Thank you, Holy Spirit. I said, ma'am, how you doing? God bless you, Pastor. I said, God bless you too. I said, can you have a card or something? She said, no. I said, can you just write down the name of your church for me? She said, oh, sure. You know, pastors.
Yeah.
Kingdom something? Mm-hmm. Christian church. Kingdom something Christian church. Mm-hmm. So she put her name. I said, can you write the name of your church from the Kingdom Commissioner Church? And she put her name, telephone number and everything. Mm-hmm. Then she said, out of courtesy, oh, maybe you can give me a card. I said, well, I don't have a card. He said, well, write something down for me too. So I wrote something down.
All right.
I said, Lord, I got it.
All right.
I went back to the sanctuary. I heard the news said, it's urgent. It's urgent. I said, okay. I looked, she was in front. I said, well, what I'm going to do, I'm going to wait until everything is over. Because I want any fanfare. Devil said, yes, don't go and give it to one of the bishops. I can give it to my announcer. I said, oh, no, the devil said, I'm telling you, I had it clearly.
Yes.
Go and give it to Dr. Shannon Cook so they can announce. I said, devil, you're a liar.
Amen.
I said, this will be done in secret so God can reward us openly.
Yeah.
I told my wife, I said, honey, go to that church to give that lady $5,000. She said, I can't believe this. God just spoke to me. Mm. He said, I wish I could just say that lady.
Yeah.
She said, but I thought that was just me. I kind of dismiss it. But God knows, if you can get me, I'll get to me. He spoke to me more than 10 times within a few hours.
Yes.
I said, well, I thought this is Sakura. She said, Sakura. This is what God said. She said, yes, we will pray to the Lord. Thank you, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. I wrote check for that. So I waited for the service to be over. As soon as it was over, I didn't fellowship with anybody. My eyes was on that. I followed up with my eyes to the place where we met for by the registration in front, where you have Sister Renee sitting. I said, ma'am, God told me that our church is supposed to bless the church with this. She said, oh, thank you, I appreciate it. I took her. I said, kind of doing something. I said, ma'am, this is important. Hold tight up to it. She said, okay. And I was on the sanctuary. All right. After about 10 minutes, she came back like, oh, this never happened to me before. This never, I'm going to take this to our church. And then, look at what God did. This is what I'm going through. And she was crying. And she was going through. Yeah. Then she found out, she said, can I testify? I said, oh my goodness, that's what I'm doing in front of me. After the service. She said, I didn't even know she was close enough to cheat with. They were very close, I didn't know. She said, can I testify? I'm thinking, what am I going to say? All of a sudden, the thing said, hey, Dr. Chidu, can I talk to him? I said, oh no. They said, Dr. Chidu, come to this man, this pastor, to give a job for $1,000. He goes, how come you didn't announce? Yeah, how come you didn't tell us what we announced? During the service. He said, he gave it to me after the service. I was saying, I'm telling you, the Lord was glorified.
Yeah.
God, no, I don't like to be in that kind of place where they announce your name and try to bring it in the front. So God made sure my daughter was dressing. So I was at home. They said, where is he? I don't want to thank you, I was here. Because I'm not too embarrassed. The devil told her that don't you ever open your mouth to say anything. Because you're already down. If you tell them what you're going through, you embarrass yourself and everybody else. How dare you obey God in spite of embarrassment? How dare you open your mouth and say what God tells you to say? You're going to find out that at the conference, God can bless you with the manifold blessings. They were shocked to the bone. Nobody knows what to think about it. They put it on the screen. I don't even know what they did with it. Whatever happened to me.
For a long time.
She was discouraged. She didn't feel like going to church. She felt, wanted to give, she only had $100 to give. She said, well, I gave you the rest of you, I know you require 1,000, but that's all I got. She came to me, she said, this never happened to me before. I said, I don't know, I just obeyed her. She said, this never happened to me before. I'm the one that always give everybody, nothing ever came back. People now stay at home, not to come back for it. Yeah. And if again they are not able to, as long as they finish talking about what happened in our church, they will beat us so badly. You embarrass yourself, you embarrass everybody, you're in disgrace. Everybody looks at you with a funny attitude now. And you went and opened your mouth and told them. God said to me, said, that lady is not looking for a show. Yeah. Some people tell you what they are going to get something out of your pocket.
Yeah.
God said, that is. As she said it because I told her to say it. Yeah. Now, all right, pow, look what I tell you to do.
Hallelujah. Wow.
Dr. John Avazine was shocked.
Yeah.
Every time I was teaching, he said, that, what happened to that lady on the day? He said, miracle. She said it again. They were doing an offering. He said, come and put it in my hand. She looked at me, looked at my tag. He said, Dr. Avazine looked at me, looked at my tag. And he, I don't know what he did. It says something, whatever I said, I shot like a cannon on the ground.
Yeah.
If I'm on the ground, I don't play that kind of thing.
Yeah.
If you see me on the ground, you're going to have something happen for you.
Yeah.
That is not, didn't give me no notice, didn't give me no notice. I don't have an image of this on the ground.
Right.
You said to me, you never be poor again.
Hallelujah.
And anything as long as you live, you never be poor.
Hallelujah. Glory to God.
You will never be poor again. That's what he said.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
The lady was so excited. She didn't know what to do. A new life came into her. See, when things get the most toughest in your life, please God. But things look embarrassing and go there to open your mouth and say, do what it tells you, in spite of what you feel.
Yeah.
Living to please God is not always easy. Pastors don't like anybody to know they're going through a rough time.
Right.
Yeah.
And look at the bottom is bottoming out. But she stood up. She said she was wrestling with it. for some time. She had the Lord clearly. The Lord said, open your mouth. Tell me what I say. Tell me what you're going through. And instead that, they went, Papa, 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 didn't I tell you? You're an embarrassment. Don't look at me with a cross eye now. Yeah? You don't have $100 to give. Look at you. What did you say? Right there. I had it up clearly. He said it so many times, it's not funny. And the Lord, I got it. I got it, Lord.
Amen.
And when I give it up to outside, so nobody will see it. You know what I do? I don't like fanfares. I just want to be God.
Yeah.
So after the sermon was over, I went outside. That thing came back in. We got to choose something right here. It came back in. The check came back in. We got to choose something right here. God will see to it that if you know the desires of your heart, He'll see to it. I said, God will see to it that if you fulfill all the desires of your heart and delight yourself in Him. Don't you ever quit. Don't you ever give up.
Glory.
I didn't know it never happened to her before. I just know I'm obeying God.
Yeah.
Our mouth was open. It never happened to me before. It never happened before. I won't know. I just obey God. She went and got a card, wrote a church name on it. It's in the basket. He said to read it to the church members. That she really appreciate our church. Let me tell you a secret. Living to please God require 100% obedience to God.
Yeah.
When we first started the ministry, the Lord said to me, He said, Bori, I don't want you to buy on the credit on my behalf. I stand before God's people this morning that we never pay any interest on mortgage.
Yeah.
We bought the property cash.
Yeah.
It took 8 years. Listen to me. It took 8 years. We look stupid. Having money but not buying. God said, when the time comes, I'm going to point you to what to buy. He said, don't go on credit on my behalf.
Yeah.
He told me that many, many times.
Yeah.
And when he said that, I said, well, you just have to wait up for God's timing. When God's timing hit, they brought the paper for the contract. For the contract, he said, lender, borrower. I said, got a problem. He said, lender was there. He said, purchaser. He's not the borrower. Because he's paying cash. He bought a property, wrote the thing. Then the economy went way down. If I would have been bought something on credit on behalf of God and said don't buy it, I would have gone down with the economy that went down.
Yeah.
I try to look like it's a small church, you may do physically, but I'm telling you, mighty things are happening in the spirit.
Amen.
So many big churches cannot afford to even have their light on.
Amen.
Hey, you're a handful of Holy Ghost people giving the $5,000 without feeling the pinch.
Yeah.
Why? Because God positioned us.
Yeah.
God positioned us to be a blessing to struggling churches. It took 8 years to get the property. I am telling you, you are so special. Thank you for your giving. Your giving is enlarging and keeping some doors, some churches open. I said, your giving.
Yeah.
It's enlarging the borders of some people. It's encouraging to a pastor that feel like just giving up because nothing seems to be working. Don't know if you can, that's a big job, you know. If you can get a pastor to quit, what happens to the sheep?
Yeah. Hallelujah.
It's extremely important that we obey God to the T.
Yeah.
That checkmate is set to the whole screen, and I'm glad I wasn't there, because I'm... Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. I said that to say this. She didn't want to come to the conference, because they come. She was standing there, discouraged. feeling like quitting, feeling hopeless, because that was the first time she's not able to give.
Right.
She said she's used to giving, and nobody ever gave her anything. At the moment when you thought it was the lowest, was when the Lord gave her a check for $5,000.
Hallelujah.
She said, it's not, I give her my card. No, I didn't have a card to give. Hold on very tight to this word which I give, because God wants to see when the openness was a check. I said it was maybe 50. But he was saying so many months, what happened? To God be the glory.
Yeah. Yeah, thank you, Lord.
That's a lesson for you all.
Yes.
Things can get tough. They can look like there's no way out of the circumstances.
Amen.
God will raise
glory.
Somebody.
Yeah.
To bless the soul, to bless the life.
Amen.
He said, prayer, shake it to that, prayer down, shake it to that, and shall men give unto your bosom. See, many of you are not expecting anything.
Yeah.
Mm. And when they give to you, pride will not let you receive it.
Mm.
Rather than anything, I'm okay, I'm cool.
Hallelujah.
You don't know everything that goes along with this.
Yeah.
Yes.
Have a discernment.
Hallelujah.
Don't reject the blessings of God.
Hallelujah.
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 Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Therefore, all you brothers and sisters, in view of God's mercy, offer your bodies a living sacrifice. Offer your body, present your body a living sacrifice. Holy, holy, holy. It's difficult to present the body when the mind is not renewed, because the body wants to go with the unrenewed mind to grab it to drink. And if you make up your mind, you're going to serve. You are destined for greatness. You are destined for greatness. Still be faithful in spite of what you're going through.
Yeah.
If she didn't show up at the conference, she will still be struggling with $800.
Yeah.
She has to dip in her pocket to pay more things. She showed up, and then God said, just embarrass yourself for a minute. Get up and embarrass yourself. That's what the devil said. Because
yes.
Pastor had to do good. Put yourself in the position of a pastor. We have to go in the corner and say, well, we don't have anything. I mean, everything's going through the air, giving the time. I think we can sit down.
Right.
You know, the kind of thing.
We're
blessed. I mean, we're truly blessed. Yeah. Radio ministry is really booming. I mean, TV ministry is really booming. We're doing good. Mm. You don't want anybody to know.
Right.
Go to tell them, say, we're about to embarrass yourself. So who are you going to listen to? Who should push? I don't believe. Mm. Well, I don't want to embarrass myself. I felt like. Say, I felt like. So you're quiet. I'll go with $100.
Yes.
Mm. Where to obey God? Truth to continue. If you don't feel comfortable, you step to obey God. If you don't look right, if you don't feel right, if you feel like you're going to embarrass yourself, you still have to obey God. Yeah. See, many of us are not used to apologizing when we are wrong, because it requires something from us, but you have to be obedient. It is an apology that God poured the honor of anointing over your life one more time. Apology will fill you back with the presence of God. Lack of apology will keep resentment inside of you, because I can even feel your flesh on, because you're full of resentment. If apology, I don't know you with resentment, you die. He fry you.
Yes, my God.
Hallelujah.
My God.
Do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is. Is good, pleasing, and perfect will. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, glory be to God. Yeah. Even God is worthy to be praised. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. He alone is worthy to be praised. Thank you, Jesus. 1 John chapter 2, verse 15. Amen. 1 John chapter 2, verse 15. Do not love the world or anything in the world. We're talking about anything in the world. Do not love the world or anything in the world. Talk about the world system. If anybody loves the world, the love of the Father is not in them.
Yeah.
If you love lust, the love of the Father is not in you.
Yeah.
Yes. For everything in the world, every struggle you're going to go through is divided into three categories right here.
Yes.
For everything in the world, everything we're going through, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life comes not from the Father, but from the world. The world and the desires passing away. But whoever does the will of God, live forever. Don't love the world and everything that's in it. In case you're wondering, what does it mean by the word? The lust of the flesh.
Yeah.
Thank you, Holy Spirit. I'm going to pray for a pastor right now. Television pastor. About the form of sexual sin. Father, in the name of Jesus of Nazareth, protect this man.
Yes.
Protect the anointing.
Yes.
Master the plan.
Yes.
Come to turn around and walk with you.
Yes.
Lord, we thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Lust of the flesh, you know, rule over him. Lust of the eyes, you are cast from your assignment.
In the name of Jesus.
The pride of life, you have no place.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
You don't take the light, you mind the music for a long time falling.
Yeah.
Then you're a liar.
Yeah.
Well, that God, every pastor, every apostle, every prophet, every teacher, every pastor, every teacher, apostle, prophet, evangelist, pastor, and teacher. Lord, protect us, Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
Help us, Lord, not to allow the loss of the flesh, the loss of the eyes, or the pride of life to live in our life. No matter how hard we get, help us to always remember where you brought us from.
Yes, Lord.
For God brings bread to the humble. Thank you, Lord. And this is my humble himself. Master of this plan.
In the name of Jesus.
Let us not meet with his destruction.
In the name of Jesus.
Carry that nothing to destruction.
In the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Hey, thank you.
Shake him up.
In the name of
Jesus. You're not bringing the grace to the kingdom of God.
In the name of Jesus.
To the powers and principalities.
Yes,
thank you. Spiritual organs in other places. You have no place in this man's life.
In the name of Jesus.
There you go. In Jesus' name.
In the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
For the glimpse.
Hallelujah.
He said, don't do it now. It ain't going to happen. Call the Jesus man. Jesus.
Hey, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Everything in the world, loss of the flesh. Loss of the flesh. See, Christ was taken in all these three places.
Yes, sir.
Loss of the flesh, loss of the eyes, and pride of life.
Yeah.
It was taken in all these three places.
Yes.
Let me have an end disease. Let me see. Is it Matthew 4? Yes. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. After 40, verse 2, or verse 1, or Matthew 4, 1. Then Jesus was led by the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted by the devil. After fasting 40 days and 40 nights, he was hungry. The tempter came to him and said, if you are the Son of God, tell this stone to become flesh, to become bread. Jesus said, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word. But by every word that comes. Thank you, Jesus, for the mouth of God.
Thank
you, Jesus, lust of the flesh. Tell the son to become bread. If you command the son to become bread and keep to be an example for us on how we should live our life, that was the big temptation. The devil knows God can do whatever I want to do.
Yeah.
He said, no, I didn't come to do whatever. I come to fulfill the desires of my heavenly Father. I made myself of no reputation.
Yeah.
I want to show people how to live in order to please God.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
That's loss of the flesh. If you go to the city, verse 5, all the city and have it stand on the highest point of the temple. If you go to the Son of God, he said, throw yourself down, for it is written, he will command his angels concerning you, and they will lift you up in your hands, you will not strike a strike, so that you will not strike your foot against a stone. See, devil misquote the Bible. If you look at Psalm 91, some part of this is missing.
Yeah.
Are you listening to me?
Yes, sir.
You don't have the whole verse
in
it. Thank you, Jesus. Listen to this. It is written, we will command the angels concerning you that they do job in their hands so no strike a foot against a stone. Bible says, he commands the angels charge over you to keep in every way of obedience and service. He's meeting the obedience and service. Look at it. What is it? Amplified. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Hang on for 1 second. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I'm almost done. Keep yourself in Matthew 4. Let me see. Thank you, Jesus. Psalm 91, Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Thank you so much for your patience. Amen. Psalm 91 verse 7. It has not before you, so your sight has not to right hand, but it will not come now. You will not observe with your eyes and see the punishment of the wicked. Hallelujah. Let me give it to Amplified. There you go. Verse 7. It has not before you, so your sight has not to right hand, but no danger will come near you. For you only be a spectator as you look with your eyes and wait for the divine repayment of the wicked, as you watch safely from the shelter of the Most High. Thank you. As watch safely from the shelter of the Most High. Amen. Amen. Because you have made the Lord your refuge, even the Most High, your dwelling place, no evil before you, not that any plague come near your tent. For you command the saints in regard to you to protect and defend and guide you in all your ways of obedience and service. In all, when you say in all your ways, if you look at the Greek thing, the Hebrew Greek thing, all your ways means all your ways are forbidden. You can't just go do whatever you feel like doing against God's will and expect to be protected.
Yeah.
God, I don't know always protect His word. You cannot violate the, when you violate the word of the principle of the word of God, then you're on your own.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Jesus. If you continue to make Matthew 4, I'm almost done. Thank you so much for your time. Glory be to God. That's extremely important. So make sure you read that. Amen. Very much. Amen. Read it over and over again. That's what I mean. Read it over and over again. Okay. He said, hey, tempter came, verse 3. Matthew 4, 3. If you say, Son of God, tell this not to become bread. Uh-huh. Jesus said, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God. Uh-huh. The devil took him up to the holy mount, holy city, and have him stand on the highest point of the temple. If you are the Son of God, he said, throw yourself down, for it is written, you command the sinners concerning you, and they will lift you up in their hands, so you will not strike a foot against a stone. Mm-hmm. Jesus answered him, it is also written, do not put the Lord your God to the test. Yes. Daniel was put in the lion's den because he was testing God. He was put there for praying. Are you listening?
Yes. Yes.
Somebody walked into the lion's den and said, well, God delivered Daniel from the lion's den, so let me go to the lion, God to deliver me. He was mauled. He made the internet mauled. Right, stupid prophet. Don't tempt God.
Yeah.
You don't go and put yourself in the lion's den. No, don't do that. If they put you there because you obey God, then that's a different game. But don't go and put yourself in the lion's den.
Yeah.
Two people did it, and both of them got more. And they were a powerful prophet too, for the ignorant. I'm a powerful prophet. So that's the pride of life. Let me just go in the mountain and just throw myself down. God will watch over me anyway. Lust of the flesh, pride of life. Let's look at the lust of the eyes. I'm going to give you all these things. Verse 8. Again, the devil took him up to a very high mountain and showed him all the kingdoms of this world and the splendor. And all, he said, all this will I give you. He said, if you bow down and worship me. So have you been worshiping based on the physical things? Have you been worshiping things instead of worshiping God?
Yeah, glory.
Or worshiping the devil? Based on the physical things you have? Mm-hmm. All this will I give you if you bow down and worship me. What's your price? What will it take for you to worship the devil? Is it a big house? Is it a limousine? What is it?
Mm-hmm.
All this will I give you if you bow down and worship me.
Mm-hmm.
That's lots of the eyes.
Yeah.
Lots of the eyes.
Mm-hmm.
Away from the Satan, it is written, worship the Lord your God and serve him only. Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah, thank you.
And if you want to please God, you have to make up your mind.
Yes,
Lord, keep me, I want to be kept, and he'll keep you.
Yes.
You are fearfully and wonderfully made. Everyone of you have a specific purpose that God has in store for your life.
Yes,
you are very precious. God has a purpose for your life. Many people get frustrated because they don't go deep enough to find out the purpose.
Yeah.
They're on the edge, waiting for a purpose, but not going deep to find out. See, you gotta dive deep in the sense of God. You gotta read the Bible wholeheartedly. You gotta not get See, people read the Bible with no attention. They read, but their mind is on their bills. and what they're going to do next, and their food prepared. Food is in the microwave, while you're reading the Bible, oh, peace, don't, okay. I shall give you this angel, okay, I'll be right back.
Hallelujah.
Get in the car while you're driving, and Lord, just thank you, don't let me to walk. That's a prayer. Happy to be there on time. Blessing!
Yeah.
To the Holy of the Holies.
Yeah,
pray in the Spirit. Pray with understanding also. Say, Lord, it's just you and me today. I'm not going to leave this place in your private time until I hear from you clearly.
Yeah.
I need your help.
Yeah.
Don't know when we are sincere and know when we're praying.
Yeah.
I have 4 children, trust me. When they're hungry for the food, when they're young, bored, you can't get that information from them. If you get, put it back in. But when they have food, put the food in. They mess up your jacket. What got the food? Are you full today? Or you come to go empty?
Yeah, glory.
Thank you.
Blessed are those that hunger and thirst after righteousness, for the kingdom of God belongs to you. God said, I want people that are hungry for me. I want people that will go after me with every God-given ability. I want people that will go after me and loving people as go after me, not being mean to people. Because
yeah.
If you mean to people, you just put yourself at a distance. People that mean to people are distance from love.
Yeah.
And God is love.
Yeah.
If you want to distance yourself from God, start hating people. Start talking about, you put yourself way back there.
Yes,
from love.
Amen.
Because I don't want you to be distant from love.
Amen.
You want to say it slowly?
Yes.
People that are mean, by bad talking, you distance yourself from the presence of God. God is in every place, but from his anointing, you distance yourself. Well, that's it.